In this specific episode, we're going to learn to drape a garment onto a croquis or a fashion illustration. And let's jump into Photoshop right away. I have already downloaded an illustration and a dress for an example. So what we'll try to do now is try to drape this garment onto this illustration. So let's begin. So first thing first, we'll resize this dress layer, Command T or Control T for resizing and transforming basically. When we resize it, we should also use transparency, I mean reduce the opacity a little bit so we can match the size of the garment with the body. Again, keep it transparent so that you can figure out the posture. Basically, the angle of the body is a little tilted on the shoulders and opposite side on the hip. But the dress, if you see, is all straight. It's just straight flat, right? So we'll now, what we'll do is we'll go to Edit, Puppet Warp, and make sure that your garment layer is selected. So first thing is, we'll pin on to places which is actually matching. For example, the dress and the croquis is actually matching right there. The next one, I think, is even here. These two places can be fixed, and the rest that needs to be adjusted, we'll try to adjust. Let's even fix the neckline here. In this case, we'll try to bring this a little down. One thing is, do not create a point on the edges of the garment because it actually damages the shape of the garment. So just be a little inside, and from here, create a point. Lift it up a little bit. One more here on the other side. Lift it up a little bit. Now, the second thing that we need to do is actually the sleeve, the angle of the sleeve, because you see the sleeve is falling here. And also, at the same time, the shape of the garment, because that can be adjusted a little bit. So what we'll do is just take the point here somewhere. Even the body, we can do a little bit more of adjustment. Again, see, if you see, I actually damaged the shape. There's a dent on the shape, so I'll undo this, select a point a little more inside and bring it further more and bring this further in. All right. Now, if you see, because I shifted this point, the dress also tilted to one side of it. Well, that's in my favor, but at the same time, now we have to do the same thing on the other side because the sleeve is a little outside again. So we adjust the same thing inside. And if you see, there's a slight tilt on the angle of the pose. So basically, again, we create another point. Let's do it in the center and then tilt it a little bit. Now, if you zoom in, there are few little areas which needs a little bit of adjustment, like, you know, there's a little bit of a dent here. Maybe if you want, you can bring the cuff slightly closer here as well. And you can even bring the collar closer, even here. It looks like an oversized collar here, but we'll manage with this. All right, this overall looks fine to me. Now, all you have to do is, once you're ready, just press enter, and there you go, your dress is ready. Okay, now that we have placed the garment on the body, what we'll have to do next is actually remove this part. Selecting the layer, we click on masking, and now on masking, we are going to select this entire portion with the pen tool. You can even further zoom in and just bring it back to where it started. Close the loop and selection. Now you can just use the brush tool. Make sure when you're on masking, you've selected this box, the masking box. And then you've also used, when you're using the brush tool, make sure it is black, which is going to remove, decrease, or eliminate this portion. So this is the area that I've actually deleted. And then here we are. So this is what we've draped. Similarly, we'll do another exercise where we use the same croquis. And this time we'll use flat drawing. Most of the times you actually finish your flat drawings and then you come to your range sheet, right? So when you have to complete your range sheet, maybe you can even use your flat drawings and then, of course, render over it. All I'm going to show you right now is flat drawings, which actually was worked on Illustrator. And from Illustrator, I've just copied and pasted it here. And now I'm going to place this entire body to the croquis. Thank you. So this tip actually is going to save a lot of time if you have loads of illustrations to actually finish up like this. And there are many people who actually have challenges on illustrating from scratch as well. And on the other hand, if you really felt that you learned something from this video, please do like the video. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel, subscribe to the channel.